So I decided to make an entire album in a week. Yeah, this is not content I usually do, but I really did enjoy making this video. It was very fun to do. Sometimes I got stuck on making parts in the songs, but that's fine. You'll see it all in this video. And the footage I have 7 hours of footage. Isn't that crazy? I thought this would be like 5 hours, to be honest, but it's pretty long. Anyways, let's get right into the video. So, this is day one. I'm not using an actual application. I'm actually gonna be using something called Soundtrap. I use this thing in school. It's really good. I like using it. I made like one good song with it, and that's it. But yeah, we're gonna be using this throughout the entire video. You're also gonna be seeing a black box in the top left corner. Because I'm using my school account for this, because I tried like making an account with my actual email and I don't have access to like all the loops and stuff, so I had to use my school account, which has access to all the loops and stuff. So yeah, I'm sorry about that. And then I went on to make my first song of the album. I then started off by looking for some good guitar loops to use. Because it's like the first song of an album. I want it to like feel like, I don't know what the word is. I'm just thinking about this on the spot because I made this a week ago. I don't know what I was doing. I was just doing random stuff, but I decided to just look through some guitar loops and pick a sound I really liked. Yeah, I decided really easily on that. It sounded good to me. And then after that, I decided to go and find other loops that would help make this sound better. Because obviously, you can't just have a guitar playing for like 3 minutes. I mean, you can, but like, just guitar. I mean, yeah, people can do that and it still sounds good. But I wanted to add a little bit more sound to it. Because, like, in my opinion, it makes it sound better, but still, just guitar by itself is still good, but this just makes it sound a little bit better. And yeah, with that, I already had like 3 layers of loops, so. And that only took like about 5 minutes, so that's pretty good. And I was pretty much done with that first section, so I decided to find new loops for the second section of the song. I also went back to section one for a little bit and found another loop that I liked. But then I changed my mind and just decided to use that for later. That's kind of funny. And then I went back and decided to finish section two. And then I was pretty much done with the second section. So then I went on to copy and paste the first section after that, because there's something called musical form. I was taught this in one of my classes a while ago. Basically, most of the time there are repeating sections, and I chose to repeat the first one because it make the most sense, because most things in musical, like A, B, A, B, C, B, like stuff like that, that's usually what's used. There's always like usually three sections, but sometimes there's more, sometimes there's less, but yeah, that's what I'm doing. And then I also changed it so that they all just play at the same time. It just makes it sound better, and there's not really a need for a build-up where that already happened at the beginning. In my opinion, by doing this, it makes the song sound better, and it makes it flow better with everything else. But then I realized the transition between the two sections weren't working that well, so I tried looking for a different sound to make it sound better. But while looking, I found another loop for the second section. Yeah, and I just used it for a transition in the beginning. But it works still. And then I went back and did what I was trying to do earlier and find another loop that would work with section one. And surprisingly, that fit very well with all the other loops in section 1. After I listened to that, I then copied and pasted section 2 like I did with section 1 and made it shorter and not have the long intro at the beginning. Like the last section, it also worked very well transitioning into section 2. And then I decided to work in the last section of the song, section 3, and I started looking for some loops. And then after I was done with that, I decided to copy and paste my first section and make it the ending to the song. And I also decided to use that one loop from earlier that I didn't want to use at the beginning and used it for the end. I also decided to have all of the loops fade out the end, so it would make it sound better than just stopping. And then I was done with my first song, and I decided to start working on my next one. And now that I've basically shown you guys my process of how I make song, for most of the next songs I make, I'm gonna do like a time lapse of me making the song. But some parts I'm gonna voice over, like this part. I'm changing the BPM on every song Like in the beginning, it goes slow, but then it goes faster towards the middle, and then it goes a bit slower towards the end. That's what I've done throughout, that's what I've did throughout this entire album. But with that being said, I'm gonna start the time lapse. In the beginning, I tried looking for some good piano loops because I felt like a slow song like this would fit well with piano, and yeah, I really liked it. After I got two piano loops, I found a drum loop that I really liked, and I decided to make that section one of the song. And then on my second section, I decided to start with drums because I felt like it'd be easier, and I looked for a synth loop to go with it. And then I also found a guitar loop I really liked, and I actually edited this loop a bit, and I made it sound a bit better. After I was done with that loop, I decided to add another piano loop, and it fit pretty well with the rest of the section. And after I listened to it, I did the thing where I copy one section and I paste it at the end of the other to make it sound better, that is. I did the same thing with the other one, and that was the end of the song. And after I listened to it, I decided to save it and then listen to the entire song. And that's all I'm going to show you. I'm only going to show you half of the song because it just repeats. And that's just kind of how the song ends, to be honest. And then much later in the day, I went back and I wanted to use a sample from one of my videos. I decided to use audio from my my bread animation. This is from a year ago. I found it funny, and I decided that I'd just use it in this song. Again, I'm gonna do another time lapse, but first I wanna explain what I do at the beginning. So at the beginning, I get the audio from my bread video.
Yo, it's just a joke, bro. It's just a joke.
What's the problem?
And then I got a vinyl sound effect, and it actually works pretty well.
What's the problem?
I also changed the BPM of the song because I wanted it to sound slower.
Yo, it's just a joke, bro. It's just a joke.
What's the problem? This is a problem.
Red.
And that worked pretty well. And now I'm going to start the time lapse.
Problem.
Yeah, I didn't know what to say during the time lapse. It just felt better to just not say anything and just let you guys watch me work on this song. Also, I let you listen to the entire song because it made more sense than to just cut it at halfway, because that wouldn't really sound that good. And it sounds better by just listening to the entire thing, in my opinion. And that was the last song I made that day, so now we're moving on to day two. And now it's day two, but it's like 7 minutes before 12. And I also wanted to make a song that day, so I decided to make a song as quickly as I can, and a song that is pretty fast. And surprisingly, I actually finished that song in around 7 minutes, which is kind of funny. And now we're on day three. And on this day, I basically just named some songs. But some of the songs I named here are not going to be the same. I changed them later on. They're not going to be the same. And I also look at an old song I did for school, and I decided to use it in my album because it sounds really good, and I've always wanted to like publish this one because of how good it was. This is like the song I was talking about in the beginning, like the one good song I made in school, and this is that song. Thank you. And if you don't like the song, then I respect your opinion. You can like what you want, but I really like this one. And to prove I made it, I went into the project of the original. This is just a shorter version, because that one had to be extended, because this is for a final project in my music class, where we were playing Mario Kart, right? And we had to make songs for, I don't really play the game. It was like for tracks and a circuit. So I got the special circuit, which happens to have Rainbow Road in it. So I did Rainbow Road, and we had to present these. And when we did present them, we were actually playing Mario Kart 8, and we played on the tracks we made music for. And my teacher played the songs as we were playing the game. So like at the beginning of the race, he starts playing the songs, and people really liked it. And I was really proud of myself for making a song like this. Anyways, I then started working on the next song of the album. Like usual, I'm gonna do another time lapse. After I finished the song, I decided to name it, and then I went onto YouTube to look for something else to sample. I decided I wanted to sample audio from Corey Extension's video, The Clock is Ticking, because I really liked what he said in the video. It's really motivational, and I really like the video.
Hey, how you doing? Hopefully you're doing well. But I wanted to ask you something. Have you achieved your maximum potential? If your answer is no, my next question is why not? Is it a lack of self-confidence? A lack of motivation? Lack of knowledge? Whatever there is a lack of, find it. Because you cannot take any more time for granted. You don't know how much longer you're gonna be here. You can do great things. It's all just a matter of, will you choose to blossom into the greatness that is within you? Or will you go by the wayside, wasting your time and potential on things that do not matter? No matter what you wanna do, it's possible. By the grace of God, I've grown a YouTube channel from 0 subscribers to 13 million subscribers. I am just a regular dude. So if I can do it, you can do it. After this video is over, I want you to get started immediately. Prove to yourself who you really are. You can outwork anybody. The question is, will you put in the time? Clock's ticking.
And then after that, I just went to bed, and this is the end of day 3. Okay, so it's Sunday now. It's day 6. I don't have much. This is the last day I can work on it. I did finish it on Sunday. I did. But it's just funny because I only had one day left. And on the start of Sunday, I decided to work on what I was doing. Like, how many days ago? 3 days ago? Yeah, I was literally thinking about using this sample 3 days ago. And also, I just wanted to say, this day is like the majority of the video. Because in editing right now, I have 5 hours of footage left to go through. I just find that kind of funny. And I just wanted to say, for this song, instead of doing like a time lapse where it's just fast, I'm just going to be like showing short clips of me making the song, because I really like this one and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Hey, how you doing? Hopefully you're doing well. But I wanted to ask you something. Have you achieved your maximum potential? If your answer is no, my next question is why not?
Is it a lack of self-confidence?
A lack of motivation? Lack of knowledge? Whatever there is a lack of, find it. Because you cannot take any more time for granted. You don't know how much longer you're gonna be here. You can do great things. It's all just a matter of, will you choose to blossom into the greatness that is within you? Or will you go by the wayside, wasting your time and potential on things that do not matter? No matter what you want to do, it's possible. The question is, will you put in the time? Clock's ticking. Thank you.
Yeah, that was a pretty long song. That's actually the longest song in the entire album. Just kind of crazy. But also at this point, I was halfway done with the album because it's 14 tracks long and Hold up. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, I added another song that I did June. I did it randomly in school because I was bored and I actually kind of liked it, so I decided it. I'm so smart. Like I was saying, so I decided to put it again. I must have a speech impediment or something. This is reminding me of one video that I edited a while ago. Yeah, that video was pretty funny. But anyways, I decided to put it in the album because it sounded nice, I like it, and it's random, and it's kind of funny, but at the same time, I don't know. And anyways, I've said way too much. Next song. my opinion, that's one of my most favorite songs in this entire album. Even though I only spent 19 minutes on it, it's still one of my favorites. I worked really hard on it. But if you don't like it, that's fine. There's more songs on the album that I hope you'll enjoy, or at least like. And with that being said, I'm going to move on to the next song. And yeah, that song was 30 seconds long. I made that in 9 minutes. I really wanted to do another fast song because I like how the other one sounded. And in my opinion, this one sounds a whole lot better than the other one. And I actually used the audio from this song and like near the beginning of the video. I really don't know why I did that. I should have used it there. But on to the next song. Yeah, that song is also one of my favorites from this album. And if you guys are still watching, I got something for you guys. So, I got Nitro on Discord a while ago. And Discord gave me an Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, code for that. For 2 months. Right? And, I don't really need it, and I'm gonna give it to you guys for still watching this, but I think it only works if you haven't gotten Game Pass before. I'm gonna to give the code. Yeah, it's right here on the screen right now. You can use it. I don't need it. Anyways, next song. Yeah, that song was like another joke song, like Bread, except this one's quicker and kind of more funny and less serious like Bread, but yeah, on to the next song. That song's pretty good too. I really like a lot of the songs I made on this album, and I really hope that you guys like them too, or at least like them a little bit, or like some of them. And with that being said, I then decided to like do a spin the wheel, because I had like a good amount of songs so far, and I couldn't really decide myself if I wanted to do more songs or do just 14, because this was the last day. And I've already worked like 5 hours on making songs that day. I ended up just doing 14 songs because all of the do more options were off of the wheel. So the rest of this video is just going to be time lapses of the last couple of songs I make. I hope you guys enjoy. with that. That was the last song I made on the album. That's actually the last song in the entire album. I just said the same thing twice, but they don't have the same meaning. I didn't mean it the same way. But this way, I mean, like, it's the last song. Like, out of the 14, it's the 14th track. I don't know how to explain this. I'm explaining this very badly. But anyways, with that, I decided to download all the songs and then upload them to SoundCloud and then put on a date that's not even the date that I'm gonna be uploading the video. Yeah, very smart. I had to change it. And now it's like coming out today, Tuesday, or maybe Wednesday, I don't know. But yeah, also about the album cover. I actually made this a couple days before the 6th day, and the background of it is just a thing from Dali Mini. I really liked it, and I asked my friend which one they liked better, and they picked the background, and then on the foreground, I just traced a picture of one of my friends, and that's just basically all the lore behind the album cover. I just wanted to show you guys in case you were gonna ask questions in the comments. But with that being said, if you're still here, thank you for watching all of this. I really appreciate that you watch something that I spent a lot of my time to do. It just means a lot to me, and I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. I'll be uploading the full album and just the songs by themselves a little bit after this video is over, and I hope you guys have a good rest of your day, and see you next time.